Alright, good day everybody. Here is my final video on the excellent little Fio, or Fio, I prefer Fio, X5 Generation 3. You'll notice in the background, I've got the wonderful Opus number 1, which I compared. In the review, I'll do maybe a brief comparison here, but then I'm going to focus mainly on the functions of this. I did end up using this a little bit, the black leather case with the red stitching, but I did like the other one more. And this is a nice little case that came with the Opus. All right, you notice I already have this open. This is the native Fio music app. It's already playing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this off, and I did update the firmware to the latest one. And something new that was nice is the addition of album art right on there. I can swipe right this like you would on a normal Android. I can fast forward. I can pause it. There, I just paused it. I can rewind to the next song. I can move to the next. I can favorite this. And then I can go right there. I can get right back in. Full touch screen again. Dual SD slots. I do have cards in both slots. And you'll notice above, I am running Tidal also. Swiping down from the top once brings it to the current song that is on whichever app you are running. I have both Tidal and this, so I can just toggle between those. I think that's kind of nice. Date, I've always used military time. I do that in the wildlife field. Drop down again, there's the menu. I've been spending quite a bit of my time the last part of this week with the gain on high. Wi-Fi connected, pretty decent coverage. This would toggle between Android mode and pure mode. I did not try pure mode at all. I ran Android because I wanted to test this function out in what I think would be considered the real world, using this with not only Android options like this. You'll notice I have a browser window open, but also the music apps. I purposely left this going. I think the most windows I had open was 5, and it did not seem to have a deleterious effect on the running of this on Wi-Fi. One thing I'll cover right away is somebody PM'd me early and asked about running Apple Music on this, Apple Streaming Music. I'd never done that because I either use iTunes or the native music that's on my iPhone or my DAP, my existing DAP X3 Generation 2 with an SD card. You can stream right this, right there. There's proof of it. So going back, if I wanted to go home, I click the middle one, and then it's back to this nice screen. Well, by clicking on that, it brings up everything that's there. We'll see. Sometimes when you get out of this, out of the Fio Music app, it asks you, or it restarts it from fresh, which is rather annoying. So you can't really see it, but I'm going to click on the information right there. Going back to the beginning screen, if I scroll right, you're presented in Hawaii Big Boy, Bad Boy, sorry, did a really nice job with this. There's all these sub-menus that you can get to right here. Well, the Viper effect, I'd never used it. I'll be honest, I really hadn't heard about it, but I decided to give it a try. So by clicking on it, oops, gotta go back there, brings up all these menus. If it is toggled on, it is free. If it is toggled off, it's an in-app purchase, and I was not willing to do this. When I get my own personal copy of this, which I have coming, I may end up doing that, but I seriously doubt it. I may spring for Neutron. I'm coming from an Apple iOS, so I'm still new. It's been several generations since I've had an Android music player, even on a phone. But by toggling these on, you get different effects, and then you can toggle on and off right there. One thing I notice is it takes about 2 to 3 seconds for the Viper effect to either kick on or to kick off, which is acceptable. We're talking changing the architecture of what's being run here, so I think that's quite acceptable. So I'm just going to leave it on because I had it there. Go back to the screen, swiping to the right. And I'm back there. Now, if I click on the little music note, that brings up what I'm running. Okay, I happen to have Steely Dan's Gaucho because this one shows up really well under the low light. I wanted to focus on the light of this, not the camera, I go from there. So I was toggling to the left. I get the songs that are listed there. Toggling to the right, there's nothing. Okay. So if I go back here, go back to this main menu, click on the file button, which is the yellow one in the middle, green, yellow, red, get it, stoplights. It brings up the album that is playing. Right now I'm in that file. If I click on these, that would take me to the SD card. I do have an SD card in both of them. Internal, I did not download any. I can go genre, and you'll notice that Steely Dan's under rock. I was playing Dave Holland before this, and that is the last one listed there, and it's under jazz. So going back this, I want to stay there. By scrolling to the left, brings up this submenu. I can favorite this. I can Bluetooth this, and then I can add this to a playlist. That's a really nice feature. I like that. I can scroll individual songs, or I can do the whole album. So I can trash that. I don't want to trash it because I like Steely Dan. This is music that came on a card. So scrolling is pretty easy. Going to artists, I can quickly change. This is just an assortment of music that came on the card. This card actually came with the X3 Generation 2 that I purchased. It's pretty easy to operate. Let's go Indie Bay just to see how it is. Clicking on that, sometimes there's a bit of a lag, but you'll notice right away. You'll notice it's playing down here. If I click on that, it brings it up to the menu. There's the album art. There's everything I need. Bluetooth, I can send it Bluetooth. This submenu brings up whether you want to trash it or the information on the song, or you click on the red X again. Sorry, my color is not better. This is actually a pretty decent camera, but I'm just not running it very well in light. With that, no toggling to the right, but if I go back there, I'm brought back to this menu, and then again, I can scroll to the right, and I get to these are the options for this. So max volume would be 120. I can change that. Okay, I think I hit the wrong button there. Sorry. Oh, just brings up a different menu. Okay. And then by hitting the back button, I get back to where I was. Do I want to exit? No, I don't want to exit there. See, I don't want to exit. So let's go back to the folder menu. I clicked on the themes is what I did, and I've done that before. It just gives a different color background. So there's the blue. Okay, I'm going to show that again. I will push this off. Don't look at my ugly mug. Turn it back on, and you notice the album art there is on there. This was from the latest firmware. I think that's a really nice addition. Even in this lock screen, I can pull down, and I can toggle between those. I think the Feo music app is not listed there because it's right there. So if I click on that, it switches almost immediately. We're talking 1003, 1004, and it's there. I click play. Clock is going, and it's going. I'm right there at title, okay? 21 Pilots, good stuff here. All right. Scrolling down once again, it's there, but I notice the Feo Music app is not there. Scrolling down, I have the brightness all the way up. Let's just make that a little darker there. Toggle on settings, and it takes me to these. Something I noticed, Relic posted this, that occasionally hitting this, if you're trying to hit the on-off, you'd hit either the start or the pause or the fast forward and rewind. Well, you can take care of that by going into key lock settings. Then you customize it. It brings up that menu. I have purposely left the fast forward or the forward to the next song or rewind to the beginning. This one right here, I purposely left that off because when I have this off, and I did have it in my pocket because I wanted to, again, get a real world feel. The only thing I would be worried about is the pausing of the song and the playing and the volume scroll wheel. I was especially careful with the play pause in my pocket because I could see that it would have. Again, being left-handed, I kind of like this. One thing I noticed, though, is if I want to make a big jump, like between different recordings of different quality, it takes quite a bit. You'll notice I'm up to 68, two clicks, 62, but if I want to go, I varied between like 40 and 70 on this. That's rather A bit tedious is the way I would describe it. A bit tedious. You notice I'm at 33%. I charged this last night. I've been getting about, I'd say 8 to 10 hours on this, and that's full on running. And those of you, when you first get your smartphones, as you know, the first thing you want to do is you want to check everything out. I do anyway. I don't know. Some of you might just say, okay, I got it. Let's go. We're good. Let's go. But I want to check the functionings, and the first thing I want to do is I want to check the battery functions. So I think that's realistic. I'd say 6 to 10 hours, depending upon what you're doing. I know Theo makes it 10 hours. They say 10 hours of music, but when you throw in surfing the web, going between apps, checking your email, which would be done via the browser unless you download the Gmail, or hopefully not Yahoo, no offense, then it might eat into the battery a little bit more. All right, so toggling through there's. If I wanted to exit out all of these by clicking that, it would get rid of everything, and I've done that. And there was one thing I was doing, but I forgot. All right, there's the web, there's the Fio. Now you'll notice, if we drop this down again, it's not there, so let's just go back into the Fio music app, the native music app, and see how long it takes. That's it. And now if I wanted to scroll to the right, personalized display, that's what I did. I can do that. I don't want to do anything here, so I'm going to cancel it. If I wanted to get into, I can scan for songs, media library, update manual. I did it that way just because. Gain, channel balance. So it's very thorough with its menus. Theme. I think that was it. Theme. Yep, I clicked on there. I did it again. I mistakenly. There's the volume I was looking for. Did it again. Sorry. There we go. Go to theme. It's going to reload it to whatever the native one was and back to normal. So it looks like there's only two. I would think you can download several. I know some people on the X3, I can't remember who it was, but he did a wonderful job of customizing the screens. So that, I'm out of it, drop down the menu, and that's it. I did not do any Bluetooth. I could not get the Bluetooth to work in my Prius. I didn't spend a whole lot of time on that. That's something when I get my own, I may or may not. I may just plug it in. That's one thing. It doesn't really matter to me. I don't really have any preference. The only amp I used this with was my Shitstack Magni 2, which gave it a, the Shitstacks tend to give it a more clear sound, maybe a bit thinner, but it did give nice power. This has sufficient power to drive everything I threw at it, except maybe my Pinnacle P1s, which, as hopefully you know, the Pinnacle P1 is hard to drive critter as it is. Well, now I'm back in. I know why it's not listed, because it didn't select anything. Let's just select something. Randomly select a song. Okay, I got something from Dave Holland and Pepe Habicuelas. Excellent album. Now, but if I drop it down, there you go. So it's got to be current, but I like that. That's a nice feature. I bet I can even get to that. There we go. Pop it back on, drop down, and I've got both of them. Easy menu operation. Those of you with Androids, you got a leg up on us. Those of us that are stuck with iOS, and we like it, there was a learning curve with this, but I'd say it was a fairly straightforward learning curve. Swiping to the left again, or sorry, to the right, brings up that. I can do that, swiping to the left, which thankfully I have not done and deleted. That's that. Many features on this. I know many people may or may not use the native Fio music app. I was lucky enough to get in Tidal for 6 months free, so I'm going to be using that a lot. I would say that the Fio music app gives a, with the SD cards, gives a little bit thicker, a little bit more full sound. Tidal sounds really, really good, especially compared to my iPhone 6. I'm very impressed with the quality of music, and I like the philosophy behind Tidal. But if I were to take this seriously, which I hope I am, I would probably work more with my SD card music. and I have much work to do with that. There's the bottom. I did not use the balance. I know one of the reviews that was just posted used both regular and balanced with all of his headphones. I've got nothing wrong with regular. Easy to charge. I believe there's a quick charge cable you can get. One thing I found is if this is plugged into an outlet to charge with the USB cable, it's slow. We're talking dinosaur or tortoise slow. If you plug this right into a USB kit, I have a portable USB where I can plug in six USB cords. I did that to save space in our little portable audio area. It charged much, much faster. And it can tell you how long it takes to get to the charge. I think going from when I had this down to 14% last night up to 100, it took me 3 hours maybe. That's a rough estimate. The quick charge, I think, can go a lot faster. That's one thing Android has over iOS is the quick charge option. It's nice. I was debating between the black and this, but I like this because the black, I think, shows smudges more. I'll probably use the clear case because I like looking at this. So there you go. Fio X5 version 3, running the latest firmware, and the latest, it updated the Fio firmware. I think I've gone through several of the functions. There's Tidal. This is pretty ubiquitous with all titles. I have my favorites there. I can scroll. I've got tons of songs on this that I've played, and that's nice that it keeps that. Really nice portable unit. I'm very impressed with this. Fio knows what they're doing. They listened to the people that were having issues with the previous generation of this and with the X7 and then the X3 version 2. They listened. They fixed many of these. They're working on a lot of them. But this is a stellar unit. Nice in hand. I'm very impressed with it. I guess I'll have to read my review to see how many stars I give it. It's a secret. All right. Thanks, everybody. Highly recommended. There are many in this, including the Opus, which are very, very good. I don't think you could go wrong with any of them. They sound differently, so you'll have to read my review online with that. Again, thank you, Fio, for the opportunity. This is a wonderful unit. Good luck to the next person who gets this. Take care, all. All right, I'm back. I wanted to put this in the case, the black leather case. It is a really nice case. It's very thick. Shows a smudge, you know, what things don't in our lifetime. Very thick. It protects it well, but one thing I found is it's hard to push the buttons. Let's just get out of that. There we go. Especially these, which isn't a bad thing if you tend to, you know, put this in your pocket. So you don't hit the buttons. Again, I've gone over the scroll wheel. One thing I didn't mention is the sound quality. I would say that the Tidal sound quality versus the native Fio is a bit thinner. And you'll notice that that it's already gone, so we'll have to get home. Let's just click home, open up the Fio. Sound quality wise, I would put this as almost neutral, but slightly north of neutral. So it's slightly warm, not nearly as warm as the Opus. The Opus has a very, very, I wouldn't say very thick, but a good thick sound. If you like warmer, that's one. I would say that this is a little more neutral than the Cayenne i5, and I really liked that unit. They both have their pluses and minuses. Against the Shandling M5, which N. Matthias thankfully loaned me, wonderful, stunning unit. Shandling they hit a home run with that one. I would say of the four of those, the Shandling and the Opus probably have the best dedicated sound quality. But if you're looking at Android, if you're looking at the apps and the ability to do other things, then that's where the X5 and the i5 come in. This sound seemed a little bit less warm than the Cayenne. I like it. I tend to like things on the warm side, but I still like this. And if someone who likes warm sound likes the sound of this, that's pretty good. Stunning sound. Just superb from the Opus. as a pure music player, you can't go wrong with that. Or I wish that we'll just pretend right there, that's the i5, okay? Or the M5, the Shanlin M5. You can't go wrong with either one. This has excellent sound quality. They all use the AK4490 chips. It's the architecture within these that changed these. With Feo Music, and your SD card, right there in there. Pretend you can see them. A little bit deeper, a little bit richer sound than Tidal, and that makes sense because when you're talking streaming has come a long way, but they still haven't caught up with this. I'm going to pause that. There's nothing playing, no headphones. Good, rich, crisp sound. Again, recording dependent, then you might have to come in with the volume. You can actually change it here, which is kind of cool. It's very sensitive, so if you get close, you can tap on that. So that's kind of a nice feature, and then it will go away. Told you. But to summarize, it's slightly north of neutral on the warmer side sound quality with this. Several people have posted on the main thread that, oh, I don't like it, like things warm, this may not be for me. I still strongly recommend you audition this and listen, because I think with the EQ settings, which I don't have up there, I think you'd still be impressed. There's enough going for this that you can work with it and tune it to meet your capabilities. So there's the sound listening on this. Thickest, probably warmest. Next would be the Cayenne i5, and then this, and then pretty much near neutral would be the Shanlin M5. If I had to rate these, I'd put that in the Shanlin above this and the Cayenne i5 sound quality wise. But that's the beauty of this. We get to choose. I mean, how cool is that? So there you go. There's the sound listening. Hope that helps. Thanks, guys. Bye.